Well, I think the biggest highlight for me is that we have the largest audience that we've ever brought together to discuss these topics. Day one was, you know, a little bit on the depressing side because we were talking about barriers, but today, day two, is all about opportunity.
The reason these conferences are so important is that it creates a level of dialogue that otherwise wouldn't be happening. And so when you bring constituents across, and you have people here from all walks of life and all different types of organizations, and the ideation, the solutioning, the exchange of ideas and best practices happens here today. And so people walk away from it feeling inspired, they dig in deeper and they say, okay, I can make the change that I really want to participate in. So I think it's an incredibly inspiring forum.
We need a lot of things, but it starts with good research, good insights, and a lot of coordination among the bottom-up investors and entrepreneurs, as well as from the top-down financial institutions, regulators, policymakers. We all need to sort of work on it together. In isolation, it can happen.
This conference is amazing in that it pulls so many people who already have kind of a connection but didn't even know it together, so they can build a kind of bigger opportunity together. And then for everyone to be either working from a business perspective or from a social justice perspective to be able to come together and look at financial inclusion and women's empowerment is a really great outcome for a couple of days.
What I've learned is that digital is not going to solve everything. There's no silver bullet, and that we're going to have a combination of high touch and technology to improve our services to financial inclusion for women. A term that I learned this morning was phygital, which means physical touch and digital.
What I find fascinating about the conference is to hear the other perspectives on things that I maybe hear a little bit of, but I don't work in. And it gives me ideas of things that I should take back to my organization that we should focus on. We don't do much on digital money, it's not what we do, but I'm walking away with ideas of what we should be thinking of for our finance partners.
Let me say that this event was a huge opportunity to be all together, different kind of actors, development actors, private bankers, central banks, and we just listened to the fintechs. And I had the impression the same message come through all the different actors. We have to work more and more together, both public sector and the private sector, to succeed to make finance for women, and this is very important.
We work for financial inclusion. Winger has been relentlessly working for financial inclusion for men and women for the past 10 years. This conference especially is important to us because when you look at the entire population of the world, 50% of the population is women, but you don't find the same kind of gender diversity at workplaces.
This is a billion-dollar issue. Over 300 million women, almost a billion women, don't have access to formal financial services. From a national stakeholder, international perspective, the issue has been addressed. And as long as we have that as an issue, this is the only forum that gives an opportunity to talk about it, innovate, collaborate, and look for innovative ways to solve that issue.